Welcome, everyone. My name is Pelin. I have been working in ABN AMRO in the last 1 year time, and before that I was working in ING. This is actually where my open banking adventure started, and then I made a very nice step to ABN. Now I will talk about what exactly we are doing in ABN AMRO as open banking, and I will also touch upon the soft skills, what kind of team you exactly need, and what kind of challenges and experiences we have faced with so far. So, as everyone or most of you know, that it all started with PSD2 regulation. Now we are making really concrete and nice steps to open banking. APIs are just the next generation of servicing and data access. Of course, you know the banking. We had really relationship managers everywhere, all around. And after some years, the client service desk was there. Corporates were calling the call centers, and then it moved to online banking, where our corporate clients are basically quite busy with it currently. And now we are trying to make a nice step to API world, but it's not easy. So every single phase, you see a very big resistance. But after some time, you also see that it becomes a business as usual. What we are expecting, within 3 to 5 years, APIs would be also business as usual for corporate environment. There is a change in the market, and open banking is actually forcing us to make this switch. We have an ecosystem at the moment. So what is ecosystem? Ecosystem is centralized, scheduled, it's their time, owned and closed. There is a hyper competition, all invented insights, spend and trash, and it's one way, one too many. But now we are moving to the ecosystems. So what is ecosystem? It's distributed, it's real time, it's my time. Instead of spending and trashing it, you use and renew it. You invent anywhere. Instead of having hyper competition, we have hyper collaboration now. And we share and open instead of own and close it. And it's two ways, many ways, and it's getting more and more into our culture in ABN AMRO, this ecosystem, where I will touch a little bit more in the next slide. So, what do we do exactly in open banking? We use new opportunities to reinvent customer experience and create new models and generate new revenues. So, what do we exactly focus on? It's transaction data, because this is what we have within the bank. And we try to leverage this transaction data and distribute new APIs as a new distribution channels, because we have different channels already within the bank, but why not to leverage this transaction data to create a new channel to the corporate customers? And of course, allow third parties to generate new revenue models for us. We have two approaches for client interaction. The first one is the direct client interaction, which is the traditional way of approaching it. You go to the client, try to get the pain points, and then come back to banks, discuss it, do the brainstorming, try to understand what kind of problem they have and what kind of solution you can, in the end, give to them. And then you immediately prototype it, validate it with the customer, and then put to production. But we are gradually moving to ecosystem approach, I said. What it is, we are currently in an ecosystem where a lot of parties are there, like IKEA, Heineken, KPMG. So all these parties are putting a couple of people to this ecosystem where you can reach easily. What is the advantage of it? Easy to connect, easy to communicate. Everyone is there. From any kind of discussion, you can create a kind of proposition. And they are innovative focused, so they do understand what you are talking about. Now I will talk about a little bit of the way of working, how we are doing it in ABN AMRO. We use their methodology. What does it mean? It's an ABN methodology, by the way. It's combining design thinking, lean startup, and agile. So, in a nutshell, many of you are aware what design thinking is, but I will give you a short summary. First, we go to the client, like I described in my previous slide. We understand the customer. Customer is always there in the center. We do brainstormings, so the understanding part is happening on the client side. And then we move to the create part. What is create? You come to work, do brainstorming and try to understand what kind of proposition you can offer to the client. And then we immediately prototype it and show it to the customer, get the validation, and move it to the next phase on IT part. So the IT part is actually running in this way. So it's the lean startup. We build, we measure, and learn. We have actually a couple of interesting experiences on this. One of them is we created two different pipelines to understand which one is more effective and running smoothly. And in the end, we made a choice. We don't see a loss of time that we are creating two different ways of working and then try to get in the end one conclusion. So this really worked out good in our team. And the agile way of working, we do BizDevOps. What is BizDevOps? Business and IT people are sitting within the same team. So we do everything from the beginning till the end all together. No separation, no silos. And whatever IT people build, it's also their responsibility to run the product because they own it. They are also responsible to keep the lights on. So what are the advantages? The whole team is close to the customer. When the business is going for a validation, the IT people are also joining. And incredibly, IT people have really brilliant ideas on business part. So we really value this. So no silo mindset, like I mentioned. More collaboration between business and IT. You see more and more interaction every day. And business tries to understand IT. They question what is JSON, what is YAML. And also the IT people are questioning what is product approval, what are you doing with the business approvals. And it's faster development, of course, because of Agile and Scrum way of working. And it starts and ends within the same team. So it doesn't go anywhere else. And who builds the product owns the product. And this is a typical Agile Scrum way of working. How it works is we have the one product backlog. It's created by IT and business all together. And then we make a choice as a sprint backlog. This sprint goes every 2 weeks. And every 2 weeks, IT and business are delivering all together. The items are challenged each other. The items that we have in the sprint backlog, they are getting challenged by everyone. So IT is challenging business, business is challenging IT. This is quite interesting to see, actually. And every day, 15 minutes, again, IT and business are together to discuss what they have done, what they are going to do. And at the end of every 2 weeks, we discuss about our deliveries. What is delivered, what is not. If it's not delivered, why we couldn't deliver it. And we have retrospective, how the team is going, are you happy? We do always a temperature check. And then we have sprint reviews. We have, actually, there we have a different structure than a normal Agile Scrum methodology. We do the sprint review internally together first. And every month we do a sprint review with the stakeholders because we would like to keep it as interesting as possible for the rest of the organization. So it looks maybe complex, but maybe very nice. But we have and had a lot of challenges with business and IT collaboration. Now I will talk about that one. It's the foundation. So the foundation, it will look like cliche, but it's super important. This is what I have been experiencing so far. If you don't have this, the team will fail. So safety, psychological safety is super important. You should create the psychological safety for the people. They should feel safe. This is number one. Respect. There is never a stupid question. You can always ask anything that you want. You can share always any idea that you have. Everyone needs to respect to each other. Commitment. If you don't have commitment, you can never deliver. Especially in open banking, you need people who have commitment. Enthusiasm. If you don't have enthusiasm, you impact the other colleagues. This is also a must thing. Openness, a very critical thing. It's not easy, but if you really focus on it, you can make really good steps. Focus. Open banking ideation. It's sometimes not really easy. Especially as a product owner, you should keep on saying, "This is the focus, guys. Please focus on this one. We need to deliver." Always give the timelines, deadlines, and communicate. and trust. You should be able to turn your back and then believe and trust that your team will deliver it. Challenges. Communication between IT and business, it sometimes does not work, but if you communicate and talk about it, especially in the retros, you make really good steps towards it to make it better. Adaption to new way of working, especially for the new team members coming from the other parts of the organizations or outside of the bank, they don't know what Agile is and they are not really used to and they don't see the benefits if you work in Agile. So what is stand up every day 15 minutes? What am I going to tell to IT people? They don't understand me. Actually, it's not like that. We faced with these kind of things, but it's getting every day better and better. Lack of focus. Some people can really lose their focus if the subject is not really interesting. Uncertainty, of course, the innovation phases, you have the biggest uncertainty. And acceptance of killing an idea. You will see it in our API funnel that we also killed some ideas. The acceptance of killing it is not easy. Lessons learned. Listen and invest in people. Don't listen to give an answer. Please listen to understand people and then do something with them. Define goals and responsibilities. It's one of the most important responsibility of a product owner. And be crystal clear what your direction is, what's your vision, what are you doing actually with this open banking era. And continuous communication. If the communication is not going well, it will break somewhere. So please always try to understand how the communication cycle is between the people. Always check the temperature, how they are doing. Learn from mistakes and don't repeat, most importantly. And celebrate milestones. Maybe it also looks very cliche, but if you don't celebrate small milestones, people do feel like they are not appreciated. You don't need to throw a big party, but you can buy a chocolate or I don't know how your way of celebrating it. But please appreciate people. And take immediate action, do not wait. And repeat the direction you go, repeat and repeat. These are our lessons learned so far. And of course, leadership, if you don't have it, most probably you will not be supported or you cannot just make this happen. So the question is, where would you like to be in this open banking area? Would you like to be an actor or a spectator? Actually, for ABN AMRO, when I look at the department of open banking and the grid open banking, we would like to be an actor. And here is how we create an API funnel. So I told in the previous slides, we do the DARE methodology here. This is how we start with the ideation. So the ideation starts after the ideation part, you need to verify it at least three or more clients that the idea is valid. And after that, you prototype it immediately, validate it again. I'm not going to touch upon all these increments here, but the most important part is every single phase we go, we have a no-go, and validation. If you don't actually tick in the boxes of the acceptance criteria in every phase, we don't move forward. And then we pilot it. The pilot is always, the plan is made internally, externally, also validated internally, externally. And then we have the closed beta, meaning that ABN AMRO selects the number of customers that would like to onboard, and then gradually we move to live for everyone to be onboarded. So for the prototype, what we do when we go to the customers, we always go with a postman, meaning that IT person is also joining to the customer validation. And we also bring the architectural design just to be sure if someone from customer side architectural-wise interested, we have something in hand. Here is our API portfolio. In every stage, we have different API ideas. And actually, PSD2 is already live, and Tiki API we have already live. The API which is almost in closed beta is a Business Account Insight API, and this is commercialized version of PSD2 AIS. And we also have different API ideas in different phases. So some of them are prototype but not validated yet. Some of them are prototype and validated close to the pilot phase. And like I said, in every phase we have a validation. If we don't have validation, we don't move forward. We shouldn't forget this trash bin. We also put two ideas to trash bin, which was a pain. I still have the pain, but they are invalidated. So we had to say bye. So what is our starting point on the ideation part? So what do we believe? We have the trust and the stable infrastructure as banks, and why not leveraging it? So keep the customer always in the center, in the ideation, always customers, listen to them carefully, what they are saying. Get the pain points, and after that, keep it simple and transparent with the prototype that you create. Be fast and secure. Security is super important because corporates are super skeptical, but how secure is it then, this data shared with the others? You need to explain it in a simple and transparent way, and keep the customers in the loop, so there shouldn't be any radio silences. They should be aware of the steps that you are taking. And validate if the product meets with their requirements in the end before you really put it in the market. And create unique experiences, of course, as an ultimate goal. So looking back, our experiences so far, market, client, and organization-wise. So feedback from the market, for every API it's different. And also, when you look in general, the functional enthusiasm coming from the corporates is completely different than their technical knowledge. Because they are super enthusiastic, but then when we ask, okay, but then can you build it? They have no idea. So there is a big glass ceiling there where we really need to break. And planning of meetings with the clients, it also takes ages. Either it's the holiday period or we cannot reach the client because the department is, in offsite. There are many reasons that it takes ages, these client meetings, to organize them. And the API knowledge on sales and the operations part of the organization, they are also not aware because people are, again, super skeptical, like API, it's technical, but I don't know. You just need to give a really basic explanation to them, like business-wise, what an API is and what it can bring to the bank itself. So team versus organization, this is a challenge. We have a new team, new way of working, new type of products, existing organization and existing procedures. Sometimes we feel like it's two steps forward, one step back. So knowing that the corporates do need digital first, 24/7 self-service, flexibility, scalability, we do believe that we can really add some value to the corporate clients to stay relevant for corporate clients as well by creating new distribution channels, APIs, scalable, safe, secure, impactful, and serving in one platform and extend data analytics capabilities and aligning with partner APIs. And these are all to ease the life of the multi-banking corporates. And this is how we see it. One platform, corporates will start and end exactly at the same platform to ease their life. This is what they need. This is our Tiki API. I will tell you in a nutshell how it works. It's an application payment request. You go out for dinner or drinks, you make the payment, and then you would like to split the bill. Then what you do is you open the application and then write the amount that you would like to send to the person and then send it via WhatsApp link. So this is what you get to your WhatsApp message. To WhatsApp application. When you click on it, you don't need to have the application, but it directs you to your bank account, and then you make the payment. Like I said, at ABN AMRO, we do believe that we can help help the clients in three ways. Improve the customer experience, and then distribute services like APIs as different channels, and create new offerings to make our customers more and more happy every day. And this is our developer portal. You can see all the ideas that we have there in which stages. This is the business account insight API that I was talking about. So hopefully we will be live in the coming months. And we are also nominated in the Dev Portal Awards for 2019. Please have a look at our developer portal. If you are enthusiastic, please vote us. And we don't know all the answers, but we would like to explore it all together. This is our ABN AMRO motto, banking for better generations to come. So let's make banking better and let's make banking open altogether. Thanks a lot.